the spaceship that exploded.
Matt from Mixed Vessel. Yeah, it's nice, it's great. It's we're just doing the weekends all the way through February, so we're trying to make the most of the audience and the areas that we're going to. These are places we haven't been to before, a lot of them, so it's really great. Somewhere like Helsinki, we've been playing quite a lot, so kind of we know what kind of crowd we have here, so it's really, it's kind of exciting coming back and knowing you're going to see a lot of familiar faces. But we wanted to do this for a really long time. We know their books, we know their music. We hung out with them. They came and DJed a gig we did in Jyväskylä some time ago. We all hung out. We had a really great time. And we were like, why have we never played together? When are we going to tour? So it's good. Having Clara on here says and cherry on the cake, because they're a really, really great up and coming band. So it's three really good bands, which is really rare. It's been great. It's been really, really good. The critical reception has been really good. I guess it's been our most successful record in every way so far. We're really happy. The title is, I guess it's like my take on the kind of Tibetan Book of the Dead. Which is this sort of preparation for death, becoming death, and maybe a little mix of the I am death, destroyer of worlds speech. But yeah, it's basically like a summary of the lyrics for the album. Yeah, it's an artist that I've admired for a while, and we wanted to have a painted cover for this one. We haven't really had that before, it's always been photographic, so we wanted to have this painted cover, and we started talking together, and he just came instantly with a lot of ideas that a lot of imagery that was very close to my ideas, and I really wanted to have this picture of somebody that was kind of returning back to the story. So that's what we had this image of a girl who's sort of returning back to nature. She's dying, but it's very peaceful, it's very happy, she's very content. She's like being reborn, if you like, back into nature, which is part of our religion, our philosophy. So it was interesting because Adam Berg's girlfriend, who was the model for the cover, she's actually Finnish, and they live in Portland. He captured the Finnish nature so perfectly. It looks like a swan. My wife's mother looks so. It's kind of uncanny. Great. I only want to work with people I really like. And so we choose to work with people that we're really inspired by. Both are really different. I guess the David Fit video, he very much works on his own, but we came up with the concept together, but yeah, he worked on his own. But really, really great videos, both really like low budget, but artists who are working outside of the boundaries of money and all of that stuff, just to do something that stands the test of time. I'm really happy with the videos for the album because each one is so very different. It's not like each one, it's not like with some bands, every video has the same look and feel, so okay, this is this band. But I think with our videos, it tells a different story in each band. Each song, it takes it in a different direction. So for me, it always has been, I grew up with vinyls and LPs. That's the format for me, so the visual image of listening and indulging in the imagery is one and the same. I'm not sure if it's the same anymore. If you're younger and growing up, listening more just to the music and really focusing on how the cover looks. But for me, it was was always really important, like to read the, you know, the lyrics, to look at the cover and really understand where the artist is coming from, what the story they're trying to tell you. So I put a lot of attention into that because I think it expands your appreciation of the music. You can listen to the music on its own and enjoy it just like that if you want to. But if you want to enjoy the cover, you know that the artist has been very well looked into, and it's part of the story, and it expands the story. I guess for some people it might not be as important, but for us it is. No, not necessarily. It's the song doesn't really start with a kind of visual image. It's more like it can be like a feeling or a sense of nostalgia or something like that. But I think that, you know, some songs give you an idea of what a video should be, but also I think it's a really bad idea if an artist is like the guy always having a concept for the video. Videos should in a way take a life of their own, you know, so it's nice that sometimes you let the director or the person who's written the idea for the video take it in another direction. Everybody sees music in a different way, so I think it's really important when it comes to videos that you give us a larger picture of the music as possible. I do like to have other people coming in particular videos and visuals. It's a story of we went to the last shuttle launch of all time in Florida. We went to see launched the last shuttle, and it was a very moving experience. And I got to feel a sense of positivity about humankind, like the human race, and that there's something more to life. That the world is going to hell, but I don't know how things could be. And I thought that would be a nice story to tell others. Mirror Boy is a story of a guy who lived in Liminka near Oulu, and he was a kind of spiritualist. He had a mirror and people would go and see him, and he would look into his mirror and tell them, you know, certain things they were asking about. It might have been about money or about dead relatives or something like that. Never anything really very nice, but he lived and died there. I saw a picture of him. There was a photograph of him in a book, and it said Mirror Boy, you know, Mirror Boy's funeral. He was an old man, and I just thought how sad and poignant it was that it's a guy who's always going to be called Mirror Boy, but he, you know, he lived and died, all he did for people, you know, and it's kind of like a vocation, you know, this beautiful vocation where people take on this thing and helps people and gets them through things, or, you know, it sort of takes everyone's pain and absorbs it, but he's always known as this boy, you know, and it was a really touching story. Yeah, because it's just a very simple nature, you know, about people's nature, how precious nature is. It's your treasure, it's your national treasure, you know, so it's, you know, it's worth more than money, the experience you get from nature. I think we've played a lot of places which were my dream places to play. We played at this festival in the Sierra Nevada mountains, and it was outside, you know, amongst really beautiful ancient trees and in mountain nature. So it was very, very beautiful, and the people that came to the festival were very beautiful people, very into what we were doing, and we had a really, very rich, like, life-changing experience. We've had that a few times with this band, so I guess what we put out, we're getting back. If you think about karma in that way, we're definitely enjoying that. You have a great time, and I think pop shows, you know, these
cosmic